Dr Carrine Teoh, welcome to Cybersecurity Asia 2023. We were on a couple of panels together,
yes.
So thank you for your contribution. Any takeaways for you so far from this particular conference?
One thing that I observed this conference compared to Cybersecurity Asia 2022 is that this year the mix and the diversity of speakers have increased by a lot. We have got a good range of topics that we touch on, and I would say that the depth and the breadth of all the topics are definitely much more this year.
Yeah, well, yeah. We talked about cybersecurity strategy and then also accountability at the C-suite.
Yeah.
But most importantly, we held our Women in Security dinner last night.
Exactly.
And I'll give the sponsor a plug, the Australian Trade and Investment Commission. Look, firstly, thank you so much for all your contribution and your partnership for that dinner. Yeah, how would you describe the night?
Okay, first of all, on behalf of Malaysian Women Security, MyWiz, a big thank you to you and also the Austrade and all the women and men that actually came and support the dinner last night. So this is our first Women Security dinner, and we hope that this is going to be a start for many more Women Security dinner in the future. Last year we had a small gathering of men and women,
yep.
After the Top Women Security Awards last year, right? So there was a gathering about 15 or so of us, and last night our dinner size was like 60. So I would say that it's a big jump.
I'm calling it the first inaugural official
yes,
Women in
exactly,
Security dinner. Last,
exactly.
last year was a bit informal.
Yes.
And last year you were one of the judges.
Yes,
the
indeed.
Previous year you were one of the winners.
Exactly.
What's your general sense of the awards and the linkage to this particular conference?
Okay, first of all, I think we have made it like the Top Women Security Awards is already synonym to Cybersecurity Asia, right? So the award started in 2020, and very proud to be one of the first round winners. And since the awards have started in 2020, I would say that there's a lot more visibility, there's a lot more awareness and also focus for women's security. Bravo to you, congratulations, and keep up the good work, because this is much needed. Women's security is nothing new, but recognition, acknowledgement, and this is actually a good pulling force to gather everyone together, to step up, to look forward. And I think the whole idea behind it is that create inspiration for everyone. And the beauty of this award is that it's ASEAN, right? It's
yeah.
for all the 10 countries within the ASEAN region, whether you're emerging economy, developing countries, whether you're developed countries like Singapore, or you're there in Cambodia, Vietnam, and so forth. We are looking for women's security around ASEAN, and we look for a professional in each country. We look for a champion in each country. I think that is the whole idea to spur the movement.
The other good thing with the conference is it gives them a platform to come and talk.
Yes.
Something that Thomville International, the organisers for the conference, allow us to do. They bring
yeah.
tend to either bring the judges in or some yeah. of the previous winners in as speakers, and I think that sort of adds the accolades to the winners and the platform itself. So.
Yeah.
Dr. Carrine Teoh, look, we've known each other for a number of years now.
Yes,
it's always a pleasure to work with you. Always a pleasure to see you around the industry, talking at every conference. You only need to follow you on LinkedIn to see how busy you are.
Mm-hmm.
But thank you so much for your contribution and the success of last night.
Thank you. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank MySecurity Media, Thomville, you particularly, Chris, right? Because of your effort, your time, and I'll say that it takes a lot of passion to make it work, because it's a long run, right?
Yeah.
It's a marathon, and I'm hoping to see more men and women out there to actually come and support the whole initiative, and also to drive and motivate and support more women security.
Well, today's the closing of nominations.
Yes.
It's June 20. We won't get this video out today, but you know, it is a milestone
yes.
Within this particular year, and hopefully we'll see you in Singapore. We're going to be holding an awards dinner in Singapore, and that otherwise that's the plan.
Yes,
anyway,
definitely.
But Carrine, thanks once again.
Thank you so much.